Every person spends time on the internet. Plenty of those people, even those who are not so tech-savvy, have viewed the popular Kony 2012 video. This film, made by Jason Russell, who works for the Invisible Children Organization, made the world aware of the Lord's Resistance Army in Uganda. This video has received plenty of criticism, yet it has been successful in doing what Jason set out to do. Whether Kony is alive or not, the world now knows about the Lord's Resistance Army's reign of terror over Central Africa, and people are doing more about it.
Joseph Raoul Kony was born between July and September in 1961. A former altar server, he became a witch doctor after dropping out of high school. As an adult, he became the head of the Lord's Resistance Army, a guerrilla group in Uganda. Kony proclaimed himself the spokesperson of God and a spirit medium. Although he was the head of the LRA, Kony did not start this movement. His cousin Alice Lekawana did. Kony believed his job was cleansing the Alkali people. Escaped soldiers from his child army have claimed that Kony told them he received instruction for all his decisions from the Holy Spirit. It is assumed that Kony died sometime around 2003. There were reports of his death from escaped child soldiers at that time, and there has been no record of him since 2003.
Joseph Kony is head of the Lord's Resistance Army. The LRA has been wanted by the International Criminal Court for various war crimes like rape and murder since 2005. The LRA has waged war in Central Africa for more than two decades, taking children from their homes and killing entire families, making fear of the army almost tangible to the people. Children commute by night, walking miles from their homes to city centers in fear of being abducted by the LRA. Kony has abducted more than 30,000 children in northern Uganda alone. The LRA has recruited as many as 40,000 children for their cause overall. These children are often forced to kill their families and join the LRA as child soldiers, porters, or sex slaves. The army is accused of rape, mutilation, murder, abduction, and recruitment of child soldiers by witnesses and reporters. The LRA has been immortalized in multiple articles and videos because of the horror it has brought upon Central Africa. Kony has claimed that he has been fighting to install a government in Uganda based on the 10 biblical commandments. Kony claimed he was defending the right of the Alkali people, an ethnic group near Central Africa, while the LRA has killed, tortured, mutilated, raped, and abducted many Alkalis in northern Uganda. Once the world found out about the true horrors of the LRA, they were appalled. Uganda and Central Africa needed serious help fast. The Ugandan government provided camps for the displaced, but the villages were overpopulated and riddled with disease and violence. They also tried peace talks and Operation Iron Fist, which fell apart. The African Union set up a force to track down Kony around March of 2012, and the U.S. sent special forces to help in the hunt for Kony and assisted local armies in coordinating intelligence and communications. However, U.S. electronic surveillance technology may no longer be useful. The LRA has split into groups and has always been virtually untrackable. There are rumors that Kony died around 2003. Rumors that can't be confirmed due to the vagueness of the LRA. Yet nothing will justify the terrible things the LRA has done and is still doing to the people of Africa, with or without Kony.
Despite the fact the plight of the invisible children of Uganda was a tragic reality, it is no longer going on to the extent people think. A foreign affairs story says invisible children and other advocacy groups have manipulated facts for strategic purposes, exaggerating the scale of LRA abductions and murders, and emphasizing the LRA's use of innocent children as soldiers. The video Kony 2012 may lead you to believe otherwise, but the video and the movements it inspired was all a scam. The YouTube video, posted by Jason Russell, talks about Joseph Kony being ignored by the world and abducting children become part of his army. Russell told YouTube his plan was to make Kony famous so that he could not be ignored any longer and could be stopped. Russell said all he needed to make this happen was for everyone to sign up for his group TRI, which means sending him a few dollars a month. While this all sounds like a good idea, it was really just a con. Kony was not being ignored by the world because he's been dead, or at least off record, since 2003. The peak of Kony's regime was not going on 2012, like Russell said in his video. It was in the 1980s and 90s. In 2012, Russell made $31.938 million, which was all supposed to go to the cause, while only $1.28 million did. Still, there's evidence in Russell's favor. BBC News recently released an article on August 4th, 2013. It reported that the U.S. offered a reward for up to $5 million for information leading to the capture of Kony, referring to the possibility of Kony still being alive and or still ruling. Although the reward is also being offered for information on the other top two LRA leaders, Aku Domanabo and Dominique Ojigagwin. There is also other evidence contradicting CNN's statement of Kony being off record since 2013. A picture of Kony at a peace negotiation in Rai Kobadanga was supposedly taken in November 2008 and was featured in BBC's article.
This may not be a pretty topic to think about, but whether we like it or not, this is happening. People are truly being killed and tortured, whether we want to believe it or not. It doesn't matter if Joseph Kony himself is currently alive or dead. His work and his army still thrives and horrifies people across the planet. Fortunately, we are getting closer to stopping this terror. More people are becoming more aware of this inhumanity, and foreign armies and the UN are stepping in little by little. It's time to stop turning our heads. One day we can only dream the LRA will be out of Africa for good.